All right, everybody. Aloha! I'm Hawaiian Dan of the YouTube channel TalkFishTV.com, reporting on the central north shore of Long Island for the Fisherman magazine, where I can be found this time of year surf casting, fishing from shore, or fishing from my Sea Eagle inflatable 14-foot sports runabout from SeaEagle.com. The hatch in my region is still microbait, grass shrimp, rain bait, white bait, butterfish, squid, peanut bunker, and adult bunker everywhere. The day bite is super red hot and non-stop producing as many snappers, bluefish, corgi, sea bass, stripers, with some keepers in the mix, and of course our local resident, the rockin' sea robins. The night bite is still producing schoolie stripers, corgi, bluefish, and there's still sea bass and the unintentional blackfish swimming around as well. Now the fall run is off to a fantastic start, but the number one major key factor for success with these migratory fish is networking, networking, networking. My YouTube channel, TalkFishTV.com, shows a 72% view rate, but only 23% of the viewers have actually subscribed. Now what does that tell you? Anglers are consuming information, but they're not networking and sharing the latest up-to-date intel. Because of that, they're going to miss out on a lot of fish. Now, I understand the importance of not spot burning. Trust me, I understand that. But you absolutely want to develop a close group of trusted avid anglers to network with. For instance, when I catch, I post as quickly as I can on the wonderful Facebook group, Long Island Salt Savages. That way, everyone in the central Long Island region knows that the fish are here right now. Now, because these fish are migrating, they might not be here tomorrow. So I also in turn post on the Facebook group Striped Bass and Bluefish Fishing, which is generally west of me, and I let them know that the fish should be arriving there in about a week. Then I mobile text my tight group of anglers that I network with, and that's how we keep each other on the bite. It's also very important to trust your local bait and tackle shops who absolutely want to help you catch fish. It's a win-win for both parties. So if you need any gear or local intel, be sure to visit my friend John Knight from Hudson Park Bait and Tackle in New Rochelle, Brendan Rugliani at Captree Bait and Tackle on your way to Robert Moses, my local and favorite Miller Place Bait and Tackle right here in Miller Place. Say hi to Misty, Sue, and Jim, and family-owned and operated Caraftis Fishing Station in Port Jeff or Smith Point Bait and Tackle as you're heading over to the South Shore. Tell them that Hawaiian Dan sent you. If you have any questions, if you'd like to network with myself or would like any specific tip, shoot me a Facebook message and I'll do my very best to help you out. Now, if you like what you see in here, remember to visit TalkFishTV.com and smash that subscribe button because there's more to come. Now get off those couches, grab those rods, and get out there and fish. The fall run is off to a great start. Remember to stay safe out there and spread as much aloha as you possibly can. Until next week, I'm Hawaiian Dan of TalkFishTV.com and the Fisherman Magazine reminding you to stay safe, stay strong, and I love you, Long Island. Aloha. Now back to you, Tim.